What's up guys, Amy here. Now GrooveFunnels recently rolled out a bunch of updates in Groovepages. One of them was the mobile responsive update. The responsive feature was there from the beginning, and even though I made a video on how to make a website responsive across 5 devices, in this video I want to give you a process on saving time when approaching mobile responsive design and not spend ages formatting. And guys, if you're new to my channel, a few important things that you should know. One is I have a playlist on all GrooveFunnels tutorial, and you can find them on my channel under playlists. However, if you're just after a specific tutorial, there's a playlist for GrooveMail and a playlist for GrooveMember, etc. Two is I leave timestamps in the description area for all of my videos, because sometimes you just don't want to go through the entire video and you're only after one specific part of the tutorial. And three, if there are any important updates to a tutorial, please revisit that video a week later and look for my first pinned comment. I leave updates in that pinned comment for you. All right, enough yapping on, let's dive right in. Tip number one, activate all devices, design and format from the desktop view first. So what I mean by this is that when you logged into GroovePages, by default, the only device that's highlighted is the desktop view. And to activate all devices, you will click on the desktop view. That will activate all the devices from right to left, and it's all highlighted in pink. Why do we do this? Because you want to start formatting and designing it on desktop so that it carries through across all devices. Here's an example of what I mean. Let's say we leave it on desktop only, and the desktop device was the only thing activated. And now you go and change the background. So we'll go here, click on the block, then click on background, and we will choose image, click on this image and click select. And because we didn't activate all devices in the beginning and the desktop was the only thing highlighted, if we switch over the laptop view and the tablet as well as the mobile view, the old background was still in place. You get the drift, it's going to be very arduous. So design everything on the desktop view with all devices highlighted like this. And that way you don't need to manually go in and edit every device, no way. So whether you're using a template or designing from scratch, highlight all devices in the beginning when you start designing out your page. I'm just going to revert this and keep the old background. Now, tip number two, format on a mobile device, but have the last 2 devices activated. So let's say you finish designing your website on the desktop view. That includes adding the website copy, changing fonts, adding images, etc. When you're absolutely done with your desktop design, then start formatting your mobile view. Now, this is really important, guys. What you do is click on the tablet device twice, okay? That will highlight the tablet device. Click on it again, and then you want the last 2 devices to be activated and highlighted in pink. The next step is clicking on the mobile device, and then you start formatting from the mobile view with the 2 icons activated in pink. I hope that makes sense. This just saves you so much time from manually going through and formatting each of these devices, because they're quite similar in terms of its layout. So if you can see here, if I scroll down on the tablet device, the columns are stacked upon each other, and the same applies to the mobile device. The columns are stacked upon each other. And because you started off designing from the desktop view with all devices activated, it kind of takes care of the laptop and sideways tablet view as well. So I hope that makes sense from tip one and tip two, because the 2 devices you really want to optimize for conversions is the desktop / laptop view and definitely the mobile view. So in essence, you format everything on the desktop view, and even though you've got the last 2 devices activated, you're formatting from the mobile view. Now, if you're a perfectionist, then what you can do is isolate each device like so by clicking clicking on it, and only that device is highlighted in pink. So you can do the same here, that is highlighted in pink, and whatever changes or formatting that you apply to this particular device only is applied to that device. Tip number three is hiding blocks on a mobile view. So what you want to do is click on the mobile and then go to the block that you want to hide. Click on it under display over here. Just click on that drop down arrow, scroll down and then click none, and that will hide that block from the mobile view. Tip number four is formatting two or more columns. So I'm going to switch back to desktop device and then activate it all. And then I'm just gonna scroll down and go over here. In elements, let's select the three columns and then drag it in here. And guys, one of my formatting tips from my first video on how to create a high converting opt-in page, you will click on layout. So remember the breadcrumb. If you're stuck and you're not in the right element, you just go down to the breadcrumb and click on it. So I'm gonna click on layout. And over here, let's just give it some spacing. It's not too close. Okay, and the reason why we want to do this is, let's say that you work with a template and there are four columns, but you only want three columns, right? And you automatically think it's going to drag these elements in here, and then you think that you can delete the four columns. So let's just drag in these elements for example sake, and then you decide to go to this four layout. So I'll click on the four layout and then I'll delete this, click confirm, and all four columns have now been deleted. So that looks good on desktop, but what you want to do is click on the mobile view and have a look at it. So on the mobile view, you will see the images stacked across each other and there is no margin, and that's really easy to solve. You just click on the element, go to spacing, and then add a margin over here to 1.5. I'll do the same for the second image. You just go spacing and margin. So this is one thing that people tend to get caught up. It looks great on desktop, but always switch to the mobile view and the tablet view just to see if there's enough spacing and margin in between. And because I'm being fussy, I'm gonna click on this view. That still looks good. This one, there's something off about it. So what I'm gonna do is isolate it, and I'm gonna click on here. Click on layout, and now I want to make it vertical. Click on this, and that will center it evenly. So you want to be in the container. So I'll click on container, and now we're going to make it vertical and this one. And now it's all centered. So you're just isolating the layout of this particular device in the container level. So I hope that all makes sense. All right, guys, when you're done with this video, revisit my video on how to make a website mobile responsive across five devices in Groovepages, and everything will make sense. So this video will go in tandem with that video. Now, if you found this video useful, I'd really appreciate it if you could hit that like button. Leave me a comment below if you have any questions, and until next time, see ya.